Hey, what's up guys, Damian here with another noob raping video, as always owning and raping those little noobs. And there you can see what happens when the noobs decide to go and fly the airplanes. Look at this, look at the noobs. I mean, how much of a noob you must be in order to do that. I mean, look at this, another tiny little noob flying the plane, and here's actually how you lure the noob. That's it right here, you just shoot a few rounds and there is the noob getting on, getting raped like the noob he is. You know, obviously these noobs, they bought the game on a discount during the Christmas period and they went out to fly the airplanes and stuff like that, and of course they get on, they get raped because they are noobs. But anyways, this video guys is about the best gun in Battlefield 1. And when we are picking the best gun, we are looking for versatility, which means that we want the gun to be able to respond at any threat, short range, medium range and long range. And that weapon guys is the MG15 suppressive variant. This gun guys, you can take it to the noob world and go on a noob genocide massacre crusade. Because, you know, there are so many noobs, and of course all these noobs must be dealt with a shitstorm of bullets. And this gun has the highest capacity compared to any other gun in the game, with 200 rounds in its magazine, firing at 500 rounds per minute, which is okay, not fast, neither slow. And you know, you can see the noobs getting on, getting raped across all ranges. There you can see it has the bipod by default, which helps you engage those longer range noobs at and you know, all these noobs, and of course you can see the paratrooper noobs. It also works as the an anti-air gun as well, because you know, when the noobs, they fall from the flying dildo or they parachute from the airplanes, it's always nice to shoot them mid-air with a machine gun and to teach them a lesson, you know, not to mess with a noob hunter ever again. Now another very good thing this gun has is it has the second highest muzzle velocity in the game, coming in with 870 meters per second. Only the Mauser Gewehr 98 sniper rifle is faster than that, with 880, which is reasonable, I mean, for a sniper rifle. And there you can see more tiny little noobs. They are parachuting down. There you can see. Look at the noobs. You can't do this with any other gun, guys. Maybe only with the Luis gun, which is another good gun for suppressing noobs and killing the noobs. And in my opinion guys, the MG15 and the Luis gun, well, mostly the MG15 of course, are the best guns that feel, you know, the you can do the supportive role better with those guns, because the other guns, the other light machine guns, have shorter magazines, and this really doesn't quite make them fulfill their suppressive role, the supportive role. And of course, as you know, there you can see the noobs getting on, getting raped at longer ranges with a bipod, which is that's what I mean guys. Look, this gun is good for all ranges, medium ranges, long ranges and short ranges, but you know, usually the submachine guns will win at short ranges. But still, this gun can respond, and this being a light machine gun also has the increased suppressive capabilities, you know, even though you have some target at let's say medium to long range, if you can't shoot at them, I mean, if they are peeking from a tight corner, you can just shoot a couple of rounds just to suppress them, and it will give you time to get out of this situation if you are pinned down and the noob won't be able to shoot back. And now, as you know, we have all the noob YouTubers who say that The BAR is the best gun in the game and the best light machine gun. And I can't say it's a bad gun, but it's definitely not the best gun, simply because it only has 20 rounds in its magazine, and this is probably, you know, the worst gun for the support player, because, you know, okay, it's good if you are only one versus one, but this is Battlefield, and there are tons of noobs here. This is the noob world, and if you have only 20 rounds in your gun, and you are shooting it with 600 rounds per minute, as you understand, you are going to run out of the rounds real quick, and you're gonna need to reload again. And quite honestly, guys, the BAR is more reloading than shooting, in my opinion, and it has gotten me killed a few times because of that, and I've never used it again. And it's a very situational gun, because, like I said, if you have one or two targets, and these two targets, they must not be very far between them, because they're gonna kill you. And also the my second favorite light machine gun, guys, is the Madsen machine gun, and well, you know, the Madsen machine gun is you know, has the this magazine on top of the gun. It's like a reverse assault rifle, think of it that way. And that's what really destroys this gun. I mean, it could be such a good gun, but still, it only has 30 rounds in its magazine, and it's not filling that that supportive role. Only the MG15, guys, this is the gun, the ultimate noob killing machine. You can take it to kill all the noobs. And now, this is, here's the thing, just because I say it's the best gun, it doesn't mean that you can, you know, just go out and kill every noob you see. I mean, you still need to play strategically, you need to play tactically, and as the support class, of course, this is your role. You can't just go rushing in like the assaulter or the medic. You need to play tactically, you need to play strategically, and you need to use the gun to its strengths by deploying the bipod, going prone, engaging the noobs, suppressing the noobs, owning the little noobs, the tiny little noobs, the pesky little noobs, look at them, you know. And specifically here in this location, the Argon Forest, this is the where all the you know, all the noob snipers sit there, and having somebody with the MG15 and 200 rounds looking at that direction and engaging all those tiny little noobs that they are about to capture Objective C can be very helpful for the team, guys. And you know, all these noobs, they deserve to get taught a lesson. And there you can see me using the gun at short ranges, which is not really supposed to be used at those distances, but well, what can you do if you are getting caught at those distances? I mean, you need to use the gun. You don't want some noob to kill you, of course. You know, the noob is supposed to get raped, of course. I mean, there is no question about that. That's why it exists, after all. So there you have it, guys. You can see this gun absolutely tearing it apart, destroying the noobs, owning the noobs, providing lookout and supporting fire for the for my teammates there. All these tiny little noobs getting raped like the noobs they are. Mold noobs. Look at these noobs, they are trying to flank us, but of course I have all the rounds I need, I have the suppressive capability, and the noobs getting owned, getting raped, like absolute noobs. And another thing that this gun can do, guys, as you can see here, it can solo the sentry, solo the elite classes. Look at this, the noob sentry tries to leave this area, tries to go away, but of course the noob hunter is here to own and rape all these little noobs. So there you have it, guys, MG15 suppressive, the best gun in the game, the best noob rapist gun. That's it. Thanks for watching this video, and remember, keep raping those little noobs.